Hi, I'm Dr. Rashmi Yogesh, Consultant Fertility Specialist at Khushi Fertility and IVF Centers, Bangalore. Single versus double IUI. Lot of women ask us, should we go for a double IUI? And they also ask us, what is the advantage of double IUI over a single IUI? What I would recommend is, if there is monofollicular growth, that is, if there is a single dominant follicle and no subdominant follicles, in such cases, it is better to go for a single IUI. Single IUI is something which is usually done post-ovulation, and this requires frequent follicular scans. Usually, when the dominant follicle reaches a diameter of say 19 to 20 millimeters, the trigger injection or the HCG injection is given. Post this injection, the ovulation can happen anytime. Actually, what happens is here, as the follicle grows bigger and bigger, there is also increase in the level of one hormone called LH. Once the LH level reaches the peak in the body, it's about 36 hours after this point that ovulation happens. With follicular monitoring, we try to match this LH peak time. In case the time that we've given HCG is exactly the time when the HCG peak in the lady's body has also happened, then look, 36 hours after the injection HCG, there will be ovulation and you would be right in time to do the IUI. However, if the LH peak in the body has happened, say 12 hours or 24 hours before the HCG injection, there is a probability that ovulation can happen 12 hours or it could happen after 24 hours after the HCG. And therefore, it gets important that we do frequent follicular scans. So if one decides on a single IUI, it should be only when there is a monofollicular growth, and ensuring that you do the IUI as early as possible after the ovulation becomes very crucial. Therefore, if at all you're thinking about a single IUI, then ensure that the follicular scan is done every 12 hours after you document a follicle which is more than 19 mm in size. This could be doing a scan, say, in the morning and evening for exactly 36 hours after the injection. This would amount to 3 scans. I'm sure in these 3 scans, ovulation will surely happen in one of these 3 scans, and then a single IUI can be done. This is to ensure that the pregnancy rate is at its maximum. The background behind this is, usually sperms survive between 24 to 72 hours, and an oocyte usually survives for about 24 hours. So the sperm survival rate is more than the oocyte survival rate. However, if at all the ovulation window is missed by more than 24 hours, there is a probability that the pregnancy may not happen if a single IUI is done 24 hours post-ovulation. And that's why doing follicular scans every 12 hours after the trigger or after the dominant follicle is beyond 19 to 20 becomes very, very crucial. One can even do LH monitoring if it is a total natural cycle, and if the LH peak is monitored and documented, then it becomes even more easier to determine what would be the right time for an IUI without having to do frequent follicular scans. If you want to really improvise on your chances, then you can also think about doing an IUI after the HCG trigger twice. And this is what is called as the double IUI. In a double IUI, especially when there is no scope for frequent follicular scans, you can think in terms of doing an IUI both pre-ovulation and post-ovulation. That is, do the IUI exactly 12 hours after the trigger to ensure that not missing on the 12-hour window, and then do another IUI 36 hours after the HCG trigger. In such a case, whether the ovulation happens 12, 24 or 36 hours post the HCG trigger, you're sure that you're somewhere there. And we already know that the sperms can survive up to 72 hours, and therefore, if the ovulation happens, say even one day post the IUI, still there is a chance for pregnancy. And of course, a post rupture IUI or a post-ovulation IUI will add to the success rate. Giving a time gap of about 24 hours between two semen collection is also helpful. As I told you, doing the first IUI 12 hours after the trigger and doing the second IUI 36 hours after the trigger would be beneficial in increasing the success rate for IUI. It will also help in another important way. That is, a 24 hours abstinence between the two IUIs will actually ensure that the DNA fragmentation is less. When I say DNA fragmentation, it is the index of damage to the sperms. So if the index of damage to the sperms is less, the probability of fertilization improves and therefore the pregnancy rate also improves. The only difficult thing would be when the sperm count is less. In such cases, if you want to increase the chances of pregnancy with IUI, we can think in terms of doing semen freezing and having one sample backed up. The pre-ovulation or the pre-rupture IUI can be done with a frozen semen sample, and then the post-ovulation can be done with the fresh semen sample. By doing so, one can ensure that the success rate improves and at the same time there's no compromise on the sperm count. However, if there are multiple follicles, one can do an IUI pre and post rupture as a rule. That's because the multiple follicles can ovulate at different times over a window of about 12 hours. There is another important thing that has to be considered while doing a double IUI with multiple follicles. If the number of follicles are more than 3, I wouldn't recommend doing double IUI. That's because one can avoid multiple pregnancies if double IUI is not considered in such cases. In fact, if there are more than 4 dominant follicles, I wouldn't recommend IUI at all. The reason is, one, risk of multiple pregnancy, and two, we've seen that with multiple follicular growths, when the estrogen level is very high, the ciliary motility in the fallopian tubes can be lesser and the chances for ectopic pregnancy will increase. It is because of these two reasons that we usually recommend no IUI or no timed intercourse when the number of dominant follicles are more than 4 in a stimulated cycle. One can even think of going for an ovum pickup when there are more than 4 or 5 dominant follicles, and this would be safer than trying an IUI. We see that a lot of women are scared to think in terms of an ovum pickup when they are counseled to do so post an ovulation induction for IUI, as they're not psychologically prepared for that. But either cancelling the cycle or going for an ovum pickup would be a better option than going for an IUI when there are more than 4 dominant follicles due to the reasons that I've already mentioned. So, doing a single IUI or a double IUI is something that depends on the number of follicles. And if a single IUI is done, doing frequent scans would be helpful to be very sure about the timing of ovulation, or doing a double IUI with a single follicle will also be a wise decision if frequent scans is not possible. And this is to be considered especially when the husband's sperm count is quite viable for the sample to give a count of at least 10 million pre-wash after 24 hours of abstinence. In case of multiple follicles, doing a pre and post IUI is definitely a very wise decision to do to increase the chances for pregnancy. However, if there are more than 3 dominant follicles, it is better to avoid a double IUI and just do a single IUI. And if there are more than 4 dominant follicles, defer doing the IUI or even trying naturally.